In the fourth year of that king, the son of lawlessness will appear, saying, I am the Christ, although he is not. Don't believe him. When the Christ comes, he will come in the manner of a covey of doves with the crown of doves surrounding him. He will walk upon the heavens vaults with the sign of the cross leading him. The whole world will behold him like the sun which shines from the eastern horizon to the western. This is how he will come, with all his angels surrounding him. But the son of lawlessness will begin to stand again in the holy places. He will say to the sun, Fall, and it will fall. He will say, Shine, and it will do it. He will say, Darken, and it will do it. He will say to the moon, Become bloody, and it will do it. He will go forth with them from the sky. He will walk upon the sea and the rivers as upon dry land. He will cause the lame to walk. He will cause the deaf to hear. He will cause the dumb to speak. He will cause the blind to see. The lepers he will cleanse. The ill he will heal. The demons he will cast out. He will multiply his signs and his wonders in the presence of everyone. He will do the works which the Christ did, except for raising the dead alone. In this you will know that he is the son of lawlessness, because he is unable to give life. For behold, I will tell you his signs so that you might know him. He is of a skinny-legged young lad, having a tuft of gray hair at the front of his bald head. His eyebrows will reach to his ears. There is a leprous bare spot on the front of his hands. He will transform himself in the presence of those who see him. He will become a young child. He will become old. He will transform himself in every sign. But the signs of his head will not be able to change. Therein you will know that he is the son of lawlessness. The virgin, whose name is Tabitha, will hear that the shameless one has revealed himself in the holy places. And she will put on her garment of fine linen. And she will pursue him up to Judea, scolding him up to Jerusalem, saying, O shameless one, O son of lawlessness, O you who have been hostile to all the saints. Then the shameless one will be angry at the virgin. He will pursue her up to the regions of the sunset. He will suck her blood in the evening. And he will cast her upon the temple, and she will become a healing for the people. She will rise up at dawn. And she will live and scold him, saying, O shameless one, you have no power against my soul or my body, because I live in the Lord always. And also my blood which you have cast upon the temple has become a healing for the people. Then when Elijah and Enoch hear that the shameless one has revealed himself in the holy place, they will come down and fight with him, saying, Are you indeed not ashamed? When you attach yourself to the saints, because you are always estranged, you have been hostile to those who belong to heaven. You have acted against those belonging to the earth. You have been hostile to the thrones. You have acted against the angels. You are always a stranger. You have fallen from heaven like the morning stars. You were changed, and your tribe became dark for you. But you are not ashamed, when you stand firmly against God you are a devil. The shameless one will hear and he will be angry, and he will fight with them in the marketplace of the great city. And he will spend 7 days fighting with them. And they will spend 3½ days in the marketplace dead, while all the people see them. But on the fourth day they will rise up and they will scold him, saying, O shameless one, O son of lawlessness! Are you indeed not ashamed of yourself, since you are leading astray the people of God for whom you did not suffer? Do you not know that we live in the Lord? As the words were spoken, they prevailed over him, saying, Furthermore, we will lay down before the flesh for the spirit, and we will kill you, since you are unable to speak on that day, because we are always strong in the Lord. But you are always hostile to God. The shameless one will hear, and he will be angry and fight them. And the whole city will surround them. On that day they will shout up to heaven as they shine, while all the people and all the world see them. The son of lawlessness will not prevail over them. He will be angry at the land, and he will seek to sin against the people. He will pursue all of the saints. They and the priests of the land will be brought back bound. He will kill them and destroy them. And their eyes will be removed with iron spikes. He will remove their skin from their heads. He will remove their nails one by one. He will command that vinegar and lime be put in their nose.
Uber Eats is loaded up with your favorites.
Now, those who are unable to bear up under the tortures of that king will take gold and flee over the fords to the desert places. They will lie down as one who sleeps. The Lord will receive their spirits and their souls to himself. Their flesh will petrify. No wild animals will eat them until the last day of the great judgment. And they will rise up and find a place of rest. But they will not be in the kingdom of the Christ as those who have endured, because the Lord said, I will grant to them that they sit on my right hand. They will receive favor over others, and they will triumph over the son of lawlessness. And they will witness the dissolution of heaven and earth. They will receive the thrones of glory and the crowns. The 60 righteous ones who are prepared for this hour will hear. And they will gird on the breastplate of Yahweh, and they will run to Jerusalem and fight with the shameless one, saying, All powers which the prophets have done from the beginning you have done. But you were unable to raise the dead because you have no power to give life. Therein we have known that you are the son of lawlessness. He will hear, and he will be angry and command to kindle altars, and the righteous ones will be bound. They will be lifted up and burned. And on that day the heart of many will harden, and they will flee from him, saying, This is not the Christ. The Christ does not kill the righteous. He does not pursue men so that he might seek them, but he persuades them with signs and wonders. On that day the Christ will pity those who are his own. And he will send from heaven his 64,000 angels, each of whom has 6 wings. The sound will move heaven and earth when they give praise and glorify. Now those upon whose forehead the name of Christ is written and upon whose hand is the seal, both the small and the great, will be taken up upon their wings and lifted up before his wrath. Then Gabriel and Uriel will become a pillar of light leading them into the Holy Land. It will be granted to them to eat from the tree of life. They will wear white garments, and angels will watch over them. They will not thirst, nor will the son of lawlessness be able to prevail over them. And on that day the earth will be disturbed, and the sun will darken, and peace will be removed from the earth. The birds will fall on the earth, dead. The earth will be dry. The waters of the sea will dry up. The sinners will groan upon the earth, saying, What have you done to us, O son of lawlessness, saying I am the Christ, when you are the devil? You are unable to save yourself so that you might save us. You produced signs in our presence until you alienated us from the Christ who created us. Woe to us because we listened to you. Lo, now we will die in a famine. Where indeed is now the trace of a righteous one and we will worship him, or where indeed is the one who will teach us and we will appeal to him? Now indeed we will be wrathfully destroyed because we disobeyed Yahweh. We went to the deep places of the sea, and we did not find water. We dug in the rivers and papyrus reeds, and we did not find water. Then on that day, the shameless one will speak, saying, Woe to me because my time has passed by for me, while I was saying that my time would not pass by for me. My years became months and my days have passed away as dust passes away. Now therefore I will perish together with you. Now therefore run forth to the desert. Seize the robbers and kill them. Bring up the saints. For because of them, the earth yields fruit. For because of them the sun shines upon the earth. For because of them the dew will come upon the earth. The sinners will weep, saying, You made us hostile to Yahweh. If you are able, rise up and pursue them. Then he will take his fiery wings and fly out after the saints. He will fight with them again. The angels will hear and come down. They will fight with him a battle of many swords. It will come to pass on that day that the Lord will hear and command the heaven and the earth with great wrath. And they will send for fire. And the fire will prevail over the earth 72 cubits. It will consume the sinners and the devils like stubble. A true judgment will occur. On that day, the mountains and the earth will utter speech. The byways will speak with one another, saying, Have you heard today the voice of a man who walks who has not come to the judgment of the Son of Yahweh? The sins of each one will stand against him in the place where they were committed, whether those of the day or of the night. Those who belong to the righteous end will see the sinners and those who persecuted them and those who handed them over to death in their torments. Then the sinners in torment will see the place of the righteous. And thus grace will occur. In those days, that which the righteous will ask for many times will be given to them. On that day, Yahweh will judge the heaven and the earth. He will judge those who transgressed in heaven, and those who did so on earth. He will judge the shepherds of the people. He will ask about the flock of sheep, and they will be given to him, without any deadly guile existing in them. After these things, Elijah and Enoch will come down. They will lay down the flesh of the world, and they will receive their spiritual flesh. They will pursue the son of lawlessness and kill him since he is not able to speak. On that day, he will dissolve in their presence like ice which was dissolved by a fire. He will perish like a serpent which has no breath in it. They will say to him, "Your time has passed by for you. Now therefore you want those who believe you will perish. They will be cast into the bottom of the abyss and it will be closed for them." On that day, the Christ, the King, and all his saints will come forth from heaven. He will burn the earth. He will spend 1,000 years upon it. Because the sinners prevailed over it, he will create a new heaven and a new earth. No deadly devil will exist in them. He will rule with his saints, ascending and descending, while they are always with the angels and they are with the Christ for 1,000 years.